Guys, I'm geeking out a little bit because I'm standing here with like my favorite writing team in the history of entertainment, Chris Minorci. And guys, you hear the title Cowboys and Aliens, and your first impression is, okay, kind of a brainless, kind of just fun action film. But you read the synopsis, and much like a lot of your other guys' projects, there are deeper themes, there are deeper issues. Talk about some of those themes and issues you guys try to explore in this film.
Well, one is, in this time in history, when this takes place, Native Americans and the settlers are deep, deep in horrible, doing terrible things to each other. And so one of the great themes that's actually originally in the graphic novel is the idea that what if an external threat brought different people together, both in the town and the out in the frontier where everything is so difficult and where resources are so scarce, but also among races, among the Native Americans and the settlers.
Alex, for this film, you guys also brought together, functioning as producers as well in the film, you brought together a really unique cast. What was the casting process like for you guys in filling these roles?
The thing that's so amazing about a movie like this is that you live with it in your head for 2 years, and then you hope and you think, my God, you know, here's our dream cast. And then they come to you and they say they want to do the movie, and that was what was so amazing. Obviously, a huge part of that is John, because the actors love John, and they know that he is going to treat them right, and they know that he will find the truth of a moment that may be larger than life. He will always find the truth of it. Even if it's funny, even if it feels broad, it'll still be real. And so that's a huge part. Our cast is unbelievable. I mean, you know, the other thing that's amazing for us is that I know, it's crazy. The other thing that's amazing for us is that, you know, a Western is very much about an ensemble a lot of the time. And it's about, you know, even people who walk in and out of scenes are memorable and they're very specific. And I think what that felt like for us was a great opportunity to just populate our world with great faces and great people and make the texture of it feel real. And it goes to the first thing that you brought up, which is this movie is very straightforward. It's not a joke. It's a lot of fun, but it is like you're watching Unforgiven and then the aliens from Alien Land.
Now, the film is still so far away. How important was it to you guys to come to Comic-Con this year and bring the film here?
As you said, because the title can be misleading. It's a poppy title, and it tells you what the movie's about, but it can lead you to think, tonally, it might be a silly or a cartoon or a joke or something. So we all collectively decided it was key, like pivotal, so important to come here and show exactly the kind of tone that we're going to go for. John told us how much Iron Man was a movie that was made a hit a year before it came out here, because it was the reaction in the room downstairs in Hall H that really set the tone for how the movie was going to be received. So we literally changed the shooting schedule around to accommodate what we wanted to show here. We would have shot the movie in a different order, but we literally picked the scenes we wanted to show here and shot them first.
Well, guys, thank you so much. Congratulations on film. We cannot wait to see it.
Thank you very much.